In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Beloved brothers and sisters, this first Friday of the month, we continue to dedicate ourselves to the most loving heart of Jesus. Let us also, through the grace of this most sacred heart, appreciate and renew within us eyes to see that God will continue to give us new things for new life in our history and in our life. To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us acknowledge our sins and beg the Lord for pardon and mercy. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are the Good Shepherd leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Clothe us, Lord God, with the virtues of the heart of your Son, and set us aflame with his love, that conformed to his image, we may merit a share in eternal redemption. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, thus should one regard us as servants of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. Now it is of course required of stewards that they be found trustworthy. It does not concern me in the least that I be judged by you or any human tribunal. I do not even pass judgment on myself. I am not conscious of anything against me, but I do not thereby stand acquitted. The one who judges me is the Lord. Therefore, do not make any judgment before the appointed time until the Lord comes. For he will bring to light what is hidden in darkness and will manifest the motives of our hearts. And then everyone will receive praise from God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
Trust in the Lord and do good, that you may dwell in the land and he fed in security. Take delight in the Lord and he will grant you your heart's request.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
Commit to the Lord your way, trust in him, and he will act. He will make justice dawn for you like the light, bright as the noonday shall be your vindication.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
Turn from evil and do good, that you may abide forever. For the Lord loves what is right, and forsakes not his faithful ones, and the posterity of the wicked is cut off.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord.
The salvation of the just is from the Lord. He is their refuge in time of distress, and the Lord helps them and delivers them. He delivers them from the wicked and saves them. because they take refuge in Him.
The salvation of the just comes from the Lord. Please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The scribes and Pharisees said to Jesus, "The disciples of John the Baptist fast often and offer prayers, and the disciples of the Pharisees do the same. But yours eat and drink." Jesus answered them, "Can you make the wedding guests fast while the bridegroom is with them? But the days will come, and when the bridegroom is taken away from them, then they will fast in those days." And he also told them a parable. "No one tears a piece from a new cloak to patch an old one. Otherwise, he will tear the new, and the piece from it will not match the old cloak. Likewise, no one pours new wine into old wineskins. Otherwise, the new wine will burst the skins, and it will be spilled, and the skins will be ruined. Rather, new wine must be poured into fresh wineskins. And no one who has been drinking old wine desires new, for he says, 'The old is good.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
None of us would like to give a birthday celebrant or someone celebrating a milestone of his or her life with a gift that came all the way from your closet. Wala naman pong magre-regalo ng maalikabok na, yung galing na sa inyong mga aparador, o isang bagay na luma. At least alam ninyong luma. Rather, we save, buy, and take something new to that person whom we love or to that person who celebrates such milestone. We give something fresh and beautiful to that person we owe a lot and whom we love. My dear brothers and sisters, Jesus, in our gospel today, gave a parable about the new cloak and the new wine. Hindi magandang ilagay ang bagong tela sa lumang tela. Hindi magandang ilagay ang bagong alak sa lumang sisidlan o lalagyan. Something new, something fresh, something beautiful is given unto us. And we cannot but take a look how God has been good to us by offering us such things. Something new, something beautiful, something fresh. And this is the good news for all of us today. God will never get tired of giving out new things, beautiful things, and fresh things for us. Every day is a new day. Every day is a new chance. Every day is another opportunity to love and serve others. Every day is a press button to a fresh start from the wrong that we have done. Biyaya ang mga bagong araw, ang mga sariwang pagkakataon, ang mga magagandang bagay sa buhay na ito. Because then, God would not give us something that is old and obsolete, but always something new. We may say, I am a sinful person, I am a darkened person, I am an old wine skin, unworthy to receive this new wine in my life. But my dear brothers and sisters, every day, God never gets tired of giving us and of being generous with always something new. With the Sacred Heart of Jesus, whom we all celebrate and remember today, let our hearts be able to receive and appreciate new things from God. To this God, who never gets tired of giving us good, beautiful, fresh, and new things for our lives.
Please stand.
Let us pray to God our Father that He bring us closer to the values of the Gospel to renew the Church and the world. For every petition we shall all say, renew us, O Lord.
Renew us, O Lord.
That the Church, the people of God, and its leaders may follow the promptings of the Holy Spirit to speak to the people of today the ever new language of the Gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Renew us, O Lord.
That we may open our hearts to God's saving power in Christ, which is much more important than observing an ancient religious practice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Renew us, O Lord.
That we may realize that the miracle of change is always possible for those who seek Christ's help in attaining it. Let us pray to the Lord.
Renew us, O Lord.
That we may become channel of the Lord's caring hands to the sick by showing them love and concern. Let us pray to the Lord.
Renew us, O Lord.
That the dead may find eternal rest in the company of the risen Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Renew us, O Lord. Let us pray in silence for our own intentions as we lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass and our prayers for each other. Let us pray.
Renew us, O Lord.
Heavenly Father, hear our prayer and teach us the art of living as a new people, set free by the love of Jesus Christ, our Lord, now and forever.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, dearly beloved, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, the Father of mercies, who because of the great love with which you loved us with untold goodness, gave us your only begotten Son, grant, we pray, that being perfectly united with Him, we may offer you worthy homage. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For raised up high on the cross, He gave Himself up for us with a wonderful love, and poured out blood and water from His pierced side, the wellspring of the Church's sacraments, so that, won over to the open heart of the Savior, all might draw water joyfully from the springs of salvation. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all of the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art
in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, that we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Please stand.
Let us pray. Made partakers in your sacrament of charity, we humbly implore your mercy, Lord, that we may be conformed to Christ on earth and merit to be co-heirs of his glory in heaven, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.